Good morning, gang. I hope you're enjoying your Sunday morning. Today is January 30th, 2022. Last night in Tennessee, there was a magnitude 2.0 earthquake at 7:35 p.m. local time. One person did report that they felt it to USGS. USGS gave it an intensity level of 3. Many people were probably up moving around and they didn't notice, but you should have noticed it if you were indoors sitting down. If you were on the upper floors of a building, you would have noticed it. But many people would not have recognized that it was an earthquake. They probably thought it was maybe a passing truck and dismissed the feeling of a small vibration. Using Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake. Let's bring it out. And it is within, you can see the yellow lines drawn out. This here is the Eastern Tennessee seismic zone. And this is where a lot of intraplate earthquakes occur. You can see them all marked out through here. This is where compression has built up between two tectonic plates. Another area here in the United States that is famous for intraplate earthquakes is the New Madrid Fault System. Tension that built up here was probably responsible for the 1886 Charleston earthquake. That's down over here. I believe 80 people died because of that earthquake. It was a magnitude 7.6 and destroyed or damaged most of the town. Prior to that, in 1874, they were having an earthquake swarm between February and June. They had a series of about 100 mild earthquakes. So going back to the location of last night's earthquake, right there, what we have going on is deep ancient faults that are taking up the stress of the movement of the Atlantic plate, crashing, going into the North American plate. So it's creating tension, and that's why we're having all these recent small earthquakes in this location. New research has shown that these low, very small earthquakes are a sign that the tension has built up prior to a larger event that will happen sometime in the future. Despite being the second most seismically active region in North America, east of the Rocky Mountains, it does not get the attention that it deserves. Despite its close proximity to large population areas, such as Chattanooga, Knoxville, Tennessee, and Charleston, this area has a history of large earthquakes of a magnitude 6 or greater. These smaller earthquakes that have been occurring lately should be a wake-up call for everyone there to be prepared for a much larger earthquake, a much more destructive earthquake. And I think it's up to the governments, but you know, they don't do their jobs to make people aware that you could have a very large earthquake, a very destructive earthquake coming soon. There's simple things that you can do, removing large objects that may injure people above your bed or your TV, you know, where you sit and watch on your couch, bolting bookcases to the wall. Be aware that brick facades on the outside of buildings would collapse, chimneys would collapse. Many buildings are unreinforced masonry. You should have a plan of what to do after an earthquake where you're going to meet up with loved ones. And realize that the phones may be overloaded. The only way you may be able to get a message out is through text messaging. So what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for subscribing. Thank you very much for watching. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.